because yesterday here we had a wedding, and his little girl, Jenny Dixon, became Jenny Britt yesterday, right here in this very place. And they're not here this morning. I think we need to call into question their dedication to church. But anyway, and Steve is here this morning, and then they're going to be headed out as soon as service is over to carry folks back up to Kentucky. We're glad to have Steve here, and congratulations to Kyle and to Jenny, even though they can't hear us. Maybe they'll hear us on live streaming or something. And by the way, this morning is the first Sunday morning we will be doing our service live streaming rather than on YouTube or on Facebook or whatever. So I think we've got it all going. And so for those that are here and those that are elsewhere listening to us, let's just have worship this morning. Amen? You up for it? All right, well, let's stand. Brother Steve, come and lead us.
Let's lift our hearts and voices this morning. You are holy. You are mighty. You are worthy. Worthy of praise. I will follow. I will listen. I will love you all of my days. I will sing to and worship the King who is worthy. I will love and adore him. I will bow down before him. I will sing to and worship the King who is worthy. I will love and adore him. I will bow down before him. You're my Prince of Peace. I will live my life for you. You are holy. You are mighty. You are worthy. Worthy of praise. I will follow. And I will listen. I will love you all of my days. I will sing to and worship the King who is worthy. I will love and adore him. I will bow down before him. I will sing to and worship the King who is worthy. I will love and adore him. I will bow down before him. You're my Prince of Peace. I will live my life for you.
Sing this from the depths of your heart. Lord, reign in me.
Over all the earth, you reign on high. Every mountain stream, every sunset sky. But my one request, Lord, my only aim, is that you reign in me again. Lord, reign in me, reign in your power. Over all my dreams, in my darkest hour, you are the Lord of all I am. So won't you reign in me again? Over every thought, over every
God's people said, amen. You may be seated this morning. Jesus found me when a poor I wandered, brought me pardon from the throne above, gave me peace that passes understanding, joy unspeakable and full of love. Praise the Lord, my soul is filled with glory. Praise the Lord, I love to tell the story of His grace that justifies me freely, and I'm shouting glory. I know there are heavy hearts this morning. If you would stand this morning as we kind of turn our attention towards prayer. I was so pleased yesterday. As I was walking my daughter up the aisle, I was so grateful and thankful. One of my dreams was to raise my family, my children, in a church that would love them. God made that happen, and it happened here. And so all that you have young kids, bring them to church. This church will love on them. They'll lift them up. They'll pray for them. This is the best place. This is the best church. Let's sing this song as we go to the Lord this morning.
I worship you, Almighty God. There is none
believe that this morning. This morning as we go to the Lord in prayer, we're going to pray for Randy Carroll. Randy's going to start some special treatments. and he's asked that we anoint him. So, Randy, if you'll go ahead and come and let folks gather around you. Also this morning, we have a very special request. Sheila's cousin, first cousin, Jarvis Hagen, desperately needs our prayers this morning. He is fighting for his life in Nashville Hospital this morning. We want to remember Pam Vincent Johnson's mother, Jan Haddix. We want to pray for her this morning. She's had a heart attack. We want to lift her up to the Lord in prayer. We want to pray for Miss Edith this morning. And she's in the Murfreesboro Hospital. We want to pray and lift her up to the Lord in prayer. She is increasingly getting worse. So we want to pray for Miss Edith this morning. Tal Greer is not able to be here this morning. Also, Lizzie Legate had surgery this last week and is recovering from knee replacement. So we want to remember her this morning as we go to the Lord in prayer. Amen. Anybody have needs you just show with an uplifted hand this morning? Amen. We're continuing to pray for Brooke and Walt and a couple of little babies that are on the way. And let's just continue to pray and lift up these precious little ones to the Lord. Let's gather around Brother Randy this morning and we'll pray and then we'll close by anointing him this morning. Yes. Absolutely. Amen. Well, we gather in and pray because we believe in prayer. There is no posture to prayer. You don't have to kneel. You don't have to stand. All you have to do is turn your heart toward God, and He hears and answers our prayers. So this morning, if you would, everyone all over this sanctuary, please bow your hearts and your heads and let's pray. Father, we thank you this morning for your presence. Lord, we've never gotten over the fact that you come to live within our hearts. Lord, you come to forgive us of our past. You come to give us a brand new future. Lord, what a beautiful, wonderful thing it is to live for God and to believe in prayer, to believe that the God of all creation stops, pauses to hear what it is that we have to say. And Father, not only that, but your word tells us to cry out to you. And Lord, as we were talking this morning to Joyce, and we were talking about a lady that needed prayer, sometimes that's all we can do. We can just cry out. There are groanings that nobody else would understand, but you do. And so Lord, we come this morning because we believe in prayer. We believe that you hear and answer your children. Lord, sometimes we know that you answer in the way that we've asked. But we always ask you for your will. And Lord, we know that you know best. And so when you don't answer the way we want you to, Lord, we know that you have a better idea in mind. So Lord, we just come this morning to trust you and to believe in you and to know beyond any shadow of a doubt that you can do in a second what we couldn't do in a lifetime. And so Lord, to the God of impossibility, Lord, we know you'll make it possible. And so, Lord, come this morning and just answer these prayer needs that, Lord, are so real, so big, so burdensome on hearts. Lord, we've sensed this morning, as several have shared these requests, that it's burdened on their heart. And so, Lord, what matters to us matters to you this morning. So, Lord, it really matters to us. And so we just lift up our bruised and sometimes wounded hearts and say, Lord, please do for us what we can't do for ourselves. Touch our loved ones. Touch those that are recuperating from surgery. Touch those that are waiting test results like Ronald. And Lord, we just pray that as those results come in and further tests are being done, Lord, that somehow or other you'd have your hand in every situation. And Lord, that somehow or other you will just fill us with a confidence that comes by being people of faith. Lord, we know that faith is not trusting in what we see, but faith is trusting in what is not seen. And so, Lord, we just ask this morning that you would just touch and bless these many, many prayer needs and these requests. And then, Father, this morning as we come to anoint Brother Randy, Father, as we lay our hand on his head, Lord, we pray that the hand of the Holy Spirit would just surround him. Lord, these treatments that he's going to be going on, Lord, they have come from very wise and learned men. And Lord, we just pray that they will become effective, that they will do exactly what needs to be done. And Lord, we just thank you for the doctors and the nurses that will be involved and the facilities and all of that. But Lord, we'll always give them the thanks. But Lord, you'll be the one that we give the praise, that each and every one of these will be exactly what he needs. And Lord, that you'll bring health and healing back to his body. And we anoint him today in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. We ask these things today in those names. Amen and amen. Praise God. Father, we anoint Sister Shirley this morning for Miss Edith. Lord, touch this dear lady. Oh, what a precious, vibrant lady she is, and how close she is to this church. Lord, I just pray this morning that you'd be with both Chuck and Edith. Lord, you know how they need you. We pray that you would strengthen them both, bring healing to them both. And Lord, we just thank you for their faith that they have, that God is a God of the impossible. And so, Lord, we just trust this morning that you will just touch her in a very real way, touch her mind, touch her body, touch her spirit this morning. And Lord, I just thank you for a praying church. That, Lord, we can place Miss Edith right now at the foot of the cross and plead the blood of Jesus Christ over both of these cases and just pray that you will just be glorified in everything that is said and done. And, Lord, we just ask today that as we anoint Miss Shirley, that Miss Edith will know that she'll bear witness in her spirit that there's a group of people that love her and are praying for her to a God that loves her even more. And so, Father, we ask these things in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Praise God. This morning, as you head back, all the folks that have babies that need to go be picked up, bring them in. We're getting ready to have baby dedication. Let's have a time of fellowship.